Hello everyone and welcome to this brand new series on the channel. And of course we are starting this for the DLC, for the new DLC. The Africa pack has just been released, so we are starting a new project. How exciting is this? We are finishing off Veluwe Zoo, we finished off the Petting Zoo. We still have a Rooma Asia going on, of course. There's a new episode coming up very soon, but yeah, we needed a new sandbox zoo, so we are starting it today. That's really exciting. First of all, I want to thank the people over at Frontier Games for providing me with early access, so I was already able to start building a week before the DLC was launched. And I'm bringing you this episode on the day of release, so I hope you guys are excited for that. At least I know I am. I have a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun. I still have a lot of fun. With the new pack, there's some very good pieces, some exciting new animals. We have meerkats, we have rhinos, the new penguins. I'm always excited about penguins. And today we are adding the fennec fox. We are starting this project with these little, kind of small animals. So let's talk about this project. So the name is gonna be Limpopo Conservation Park. And you might have seen it. I did a little contest on the channel over on the Discord, and I also posted it on YouTube. There was a little name contest going on, so someone won. Yeah, and the name was Limpopo. I really like the name Limpopo, and it's easy to pronounce for me. It's actually a region in South Africa where these animals would live. So this conservation park is mostly focused on the white rhinos. We're gonna start on that in the next episode, and we are actually dedicating two episodes, maybe even three, to the rhinos only. So that's gonna be a big thing. And so the Limpopo, that's a region over there, and I like the name of it. It's easy to pronounce for me, so that's also very important. And the winner will be contacted by email, and we'll get the pack on the day of release. So I hope they will enjoy it, and everyone will send in the names. Thank you very much. I had a lot of names coming up. I think I had like 40 people that put their names in, so it was really hard to choose. And I discussed it a bit with my moderators, of course, and we came up with this one. So I hope you guys like it. So some little information about this park. So as I said, it's gonna be a conservation park, so mostly focused on the conservation of the white rhinos, and at least that's where it started. After that they added a few more animals, and it's getting bigger and bigger. And the series itself, I want to get around like 10 episodes for this little project. It's not gonna be a new Veluwe Zoo, so we're not gonna do like 40 episodes or whatever. We're gonna see where we are heading once we get like to 10 episodes, once we got all the new Africa DLC animals in there. So we're gonna add the penguin, meerkats, and the fennec fox today, the rhinos of course. But I'm also thinking about creating a little safari area for like gazelles and springboks, stuff like that. So we're gonna add that, little restaurant area maybe. I got it all more or less planned out, as you can see. We started the video, we already had like a concrete shell, so I already put down some buildings, some shapes, and at least I know the size of how I was gonna start. And I'm actually starting not with the entrance but with the fennec fox habitat. But I already laid down the where the entrance is gonna be and where the buildings are gonna be, so that was a bit easier. But I thought people were not really excited on the day of release to see a new entrance build, so that's why I decided to start with a habitat. After this we're gonna do the rhino habitat, and it's already finished while I'm recording this, so I'm super excited to share with you guys, because I'm trying out some new stuff, as you might see over here. We're going for a bit more realistic, still modern but minimalistic vibes. This is highly inspired by one of the builds in the contest I got by Simus. And somehow Simus and Leader have a building style that really attracts me and makes me interested in the game again. So I'm trying out some stuff, inspired by them, giving it my own Zoof experience and adding a little bit more of my building style in it. And I really like the result of this little habitat in the end. So what I'm doing right now, I laid down the building, I added some details, and I started with the habitat again with a square. And I was like, yeah, we're not gonna do that. We're gonna make it look a bit more interesting. So that's what we're doing right now, creating a little bit of a different shape, more circles in it. And I think it looks much, much better in the end. And you will see it in the editing of the video. I spent a lot of time on this habitat. The speed build videos are not going to be as smooth as in Veluwe Zoo, for example. Normally, for Veluwe Zoo, I just sit down and start building and never really change anything. But for this project, I want to experiment a bit more. And if I don't like it, I'm just going to replace it. And I'm going to redo it, as you saw already with the building. I didn't like the wood pieces I used and changed it with the plaster pieces, which are new, by the way, in the game. And you will see a lot of stuff like this coming up in the next episode as well with the rhino habitat. I changed a couple of things throughout the build, and I think that will give me the best results. Oh, and we're going in with my favorite new pieces, the little grass pieces. They are wonderful. I didn't think I would ever be so excited about pieces of grass in a game, but they are just perfect. They look much better than the elephant grass, for example. And especially in this kind of a region, it just looks so much better. And a very important thing that we are doing right now is we're changing the color. There's someone that made like a really nice blueprint on the workshop who matched the colors of the rocks in-game with the new faux rock. So you could just copy and paste the color code for them. Then you will have a perfect match with the savannah rocks. But that's what we just did. And I really like the look of it. The new foliage in the pack is wonderful. I really like it. And the new trees, the new palm trees, the new grass. There's like a little deserty kind of bush, which is perfect. And there are a couple of great pieces. I'm not a big fan of like the mosaic pieces, but I did think of how I'm gonna use it, and I'm probably gonna use it in the indoor section of the rhino habitat. I have an idea for it, but it will be in episode 3, and you won't see it in this one. I did add up a couple of plates, something like that. Later on the inside, I made like a small little exhibition museum area in this building. And you will see it later on. So what we're doing right now, we are creating the indoor section of this habitat. I did a little bit of research. I saw a couple of pictures, but I also did read that the fennec fox is actually a nocturnal animal. So I thought it would need a proper indoor area to stay during the day, and we will add some red lighting in there, so it literally looks like a nocturnal house. You will see that in the end. And the pathing, I struggled with it. I wasn't sure if I was gonna cover up everything, and I ended up with this path. And then I'm gonna add all of these like temple rocks, which I just added, and it gives a nice little effect. Some randomness in it, some nice little rocks, and I think it gives you a nice little effect. Some new wood pieces that are in the new pack. Oh, very exciting. Recolorable. Everything is recolorable again. But I like the texture on it. It looks broken. It fits with the African theme. If you're gonna go for like super modern or whatever, then it doesn't really fit, I think. But for this case, it's perfect, and that's why I wanted to start something new as well. Also a new piece, the rope piece, it's recolorable. Very exciting. Even more grass, very important. Oh, and the archer, you just saw that one. I made a big mistake in my first Planet Coaster build, for example, that I didn't check it with the archer. And then the scale was a bit off, but I almost finished the build by then. So it's very important that you check it before you start building, and start building on scale. Now, the pieces in Planet Zoo are much better than in Planet Coaster when it comes down to scale. So you don't make that mistake that easy in Planet Zoo. But in Planet Coaster, it's really easy to make that mistake. So I'm changing all the concrete pieces. to these matte wall pieces. They are recolorable, they have a nice texture on it. And I'm not sure if it was introduced in this pack, but now you also have like 2 meter and the very small pieces of these mod walls, which don't have a grid. So you can basically do anything with it. And that's very exciting. I like that. So I thought, okay, I'm gonna use it. Some little fence pieces, also new. And I think most people are excited about these new pieces. They are included in the free update, so it's not part of the Africa DLC. But we finally have these fence pieces. They're very small ones, up to 0.5 meter square pieces. That the chain link fences, everyone was asking about it. So we finally got them. And I think Frontier did a really good job with this pack. A lot of requested animals like the African penguin and the meerkats. And I think the fennec fox was also requested animal. So I'm actually excited about this pack. I have to admit I was a little bit disappointed with the animal pack, but mostly because that's how I play the game. You know, I'm here for the creative aspect, and I like to build some nice stuff. And with an animal pack only, it didn't really get me back into the game or something. But this pack did. I actually spent over 50 hours in this park already while recording this. So it really got me back into the game. And you might have seen it on the channel as well. There's a lot more coming up. You've seen Veluwe Zoo episodes popping up here and then. Rumah Asia, as I said, is returning very soon. We are working hard on it. I hope to release a video every week. I don't want to burn myself out with the game again. So I'm trying to put a episode out every week. Of course, in the first week, you're going to see multiple episodes because then the hype is still going on. People want to see stuff from the pack. But as we all know, it dies out after a week. And then we could just, you know, relax a little and continue with this part. Some realistic touches over here. We put some pillars. Otherwise, the roof that we're going to put in doesn't really have a structure to hold it up. Covering some stuff up. We needed something over here, so I thought, yeah, let's do some rocks. Rocks are always nice. And this is a little kid play area. I need to create like a little sign, probably a custom image that says, live like a fennec fox, because they live like in tunnels, and during the day they can sleep over there. And I thought it would be cool for kids to play around there. The little shelter area actually works inside. I know it looks kind of small, and that was one of the things that worried me with these small animals, that the hitboxes would be too big, because that's always a problem in Planet Zoo for me, that the hitboxes are huge. But it works, yeah, and the animals are able to use that little shelter space, so I'm happy with that. So the roof, inspired by Rumah Asia, I used the arch shapes for that in Rumah Asia, and it works much better than plaster pieces, because with the arch shapes you can just have some overlay. You don't have to think about the cross fighting, because it really it doesn't really have it. And in Rumah Asia we put like this modern window in, but I thought that didn't really fit. Of course it's kind of a mix that we're going for, so it's not 100% modern in this build, but it's more like minimalistic. It's still, you have to keep in mind, it's gonna be in Africa, so I think it's not like a high budget build or something, so we have to think about that. And also with the rhino build, I'm gonna try to keep that in mind and not going for like trillion amount of details and nicely modern architecture or whatever. It's gonna be simplistic, as you can see with the building. Adding a nice little trim over here, adding some details to the roof, very important. I need to add a drain. That's the only thing I thought of today, that I still need to do that. So you're not gonna see it in this video, but I'm gonna go back into these buildings every now and then. If people have comments, if you have anything that you don't like about it, or being like, yeah, this is not really realistic, you should change that. Of course, we can always do it while we are building in this project. So I'm gonna open up the windows here because it's very hot in Africa. As you might know, it's like 40 degrees Well, 37, I can't really read it. It's in the recording. If you can read it, then you know how hot it is over there. Very hot. Yeah. Okay. The tree, yeah, gone again. Putting some rocks down there. And I thought I remembered there was a really nice little panic fox statue. And I put these down and I was like, yeah, it's a little bit too small. But we're gonna use it later on. I thought of really something, yeah, something new, something cool, I think. We're gonna add that to the indoor part. And here I found these mud wall pieces. And you can change the color, as you can see. Later on we added a bit more detail to these like pillars, but it's all the new plaster pieces. We're gonna do the entrance, of course, with the new wood pieces, these wooden beams. A nice little entrance over there. I need to add a door. Gonna do that later on. Need to come up with the cool design. But I spent so many hours in this build. You can see the video is quite long, but I had like 45 minutes of recording. I had to cut it out some parts. Of course, when I'm placing like a trillion rocks in the same way as I already did, I'm gonna cut that out. So you guys won't see me placing rocks for 10 minutes. I thought that would be useful. Some lighting, as I already discussed, some red lighting on the indoor section. And yeah, on the outdoor over here, there's gonna be a little backstage area. We're gonna make it a bit more detailed in the next episode. But also the outside area. Yeah, some little details. The mosaic pieces. I thought it would be cool to make this little brick effect with it. I'm not 100% sure about it yet. One way I like it, the one way, other way I don't. So let me know down in the comments what you think. Should I remove it? Yes or no? I'm not sure about it yet. I'm adding some wood to the walls over here so the animals can scratch that instead of destroying the walls. Putting some beams over here to make it look a little bit more interesting. Changing the colors a bit. Blend it in a little bit better with the wall. Even more mosaic pieces. A lot of pieces in this build. I'm not really thinking about piece count because it's not going to be a huge project, so we don't have to think about game performance or whatever. You won't see any guests in it yet. Of course, we don't have an entrance yet, so there's no guests in it. But in the end, there will be. Of course, it's all planned out. The layout is inspired by a zoo in Melbourne, Australia. There's like a elephant section over there, and I found a little master plan of it and like a little map, and I thought it would be cool to use that as a layout, learn a bit more of how zoos are, make it look a little bit more interesting. That's one of the mistakes I made with Veluwe Zoo. I didn't really plan anything. And then it came out wrong in the other way. So I already laid down a lot of the pathing and some of the buildings where I wanted it. I know where the habitats are going. So now it's only just a matter of, building, finishing up everything. And that's what they're gonna do. I just added the aircon things to the roof. I think by now everyone knows them, but they are made by Mr. Gomez, I think. Yeah, Mr. Gomez made these. They are incredible, a nice little detail to your roofing, make it look a little bit more interesting. Of course, open windows and air conditioning, it's a weird combination, but I did it anyway. What we're building right now, that's something I was kind of proud of. Just like a little exhibition over here, some education stuff, so people can't really see the animals up close, of course. They cannot really touch it. They don't know how big they are. I really like the little enrichment item, by the way, the log. So I thought, okay, let's put these statues in so people can see it, see how these animals live and how big they actually are, and they can see them up close. In the end, I also added another planter thing, and that was it. I hope you guys enjoyed. Like, subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.